But you're facing a shitload of years between bars. At least he'll get a life. What I don't get...
Time for Sean's power to activate.
How two kids can destroy so much stuff. I mean, anywhere you went, something blew up. Seriously.
Not everywhere.
How?
We're supervillains. Random accidents?
Those were just random accidents. Yeah, it's crazy, but it just happens around us. Can't explain it.
Something blew up at the hospital.
Listen, once is an accident. Twice is luck. Three times is enemy action. Whoa!
Enemy,
what is that?
Action?
Sir? I don't think you should...
Keep your ass in that seat.
Is he breaking free? Nice.
Sean!
You okay?
Nice.
How do you feel?
I'm okay. Just a little headache. Hold on.
You're the best.
Dude, we gotta go.
Get the hell out of here. Yeah,
hold on.
Does he have a key?
Is he okay?
Set of keys?
I wanted to rescue you, but I had to use my power.
Yeah, I know.
I didn't want to hurt him.
He's okay. Don't worry.
But you're all wrapped up and good now. Can we get the keys off the officer?
Hey! Hey!
Mom,
you gotta go.
Nothing personal, dude.
He's got enough. He's still the key.
Sean, who are these people?
Well, Carla and Diego. They came all the way from Mexico and got thrown in jail for it. As for the others, they're the ones who tried to shoot you.
What? Yep. They got locked up?
Not try to.
Good.
They did
go
shoot
to hell.
Shall we try to make peace with these morons?
Leave them. Neither.
He's up for the count.
Do we need keys?
Keys. I've really made a mess.
Good thinking, Daniel.
Sorry.
Okay, hands up!
Shit!
Oh, crap.
Hands up! Shoot! Hands up!
Do not move! Wait!
Sean?
Stay back, Daniel.
Let me think.
Sean, what do I do?
Quick. I gotta find something to stop them.
We got multiple officers down. Shoot them now!
Distract.
The chair. They're dangerous! Be careful!
We will shoot if we need to! Understand?
I'm scared.
The muck, dude.
What the fuck?
Okay, what the fuck? Do not move!
We're not moving.
This is a...
Throw that locker.
We didn't
want to
move.
Hurt anybody anymore.
Something
you
else
saved
moved.
Us. You had no choice. Now, let's bail.
Sean, I think our things are in there.
Things?
Our shit is still here.
What did you do?
Finally, good news.
Step back.
Don't move. I'll be right back.
Okay, but be quick.
Okay. Being quick. Well, they told us not to move.
Look at that.
So we didn't.
Crime Central.
Something else moved instead. Walkie-talkie?
They must really feel threatened to put so much effort into this.
Should we grab it? Can't grab it. Take that.
After this, you're not gonna hunt shit anymore.
Oh, that's their stuff. The vigilante stuff.
Bet it belongs to one of these trigger-happy people.
All this stuff does.
There's probably more of them coming! Let's go!
Flagpin? Hold on.
Pretty good memory.
It's like a souvenir.
From a pretty bad place.
I know. There's no time to be doing this, but... All right, let's
Come
go.
On, Sean! We gotta go!
Here we go.
We would be so dead if we didn't have Daniel's power. I hate that he has to use this for all this shit.
Yep. We don't like it. Wow, freedom.
Take it out, Daniel.
Yeah, we didn't bother to look for keys, so you're gonna have to do that.
Wow.
Time to go.
Dramatic.
Hurry, Sean!
They have
drive!
Minimal staff here. El Rey? Where the hell is El Rey? I mean, I know. Arizona, somewhere. Port of entry, 3,500 feet. Oh, it's a border. Border town,
no,
I guess.
Nobody is chasing us.
That's pretty amazing.
Not yet.
Emergency! This is an all points bulletin for every unit in the area. Two prisoners, both teenagers, have escaped using violent force from the El Rey police station. They are considered armed and dangerous. Repeat.
Armed with the power of our mind.
Are we still going to Mexico?
Hell yes.
Yeah. We got nowhere else to go.
You gotta make the car fly, Daniel. Car flies. That's your ultimate test.
Sean.
What?
It's the 4th of July.
Yeah.
Our first one without Dad.
True.
You're right.
Remember how he was so into fireworks every year? He always made us go too early so we could get a good spot.
I know. He was so corny. He said he was proud to live in this country.
Look out for roadblocks. Are we trying to find our way back to the same part of the wall?
Shit.
Well, don't go through there. Go through the hole you made in the wall. Weapons and ammunition illegal.
Sean, what are we gonna do?
This isn't the way to go.
Sean!
I'm supposed to go through the desert. Can you stop bullets, Daniel? Make like a force wall. Come on, Sean. Lead.
You know that day?
You're the leader.
In Seattle?
Or you can talk about that crap later.
The date Dad was shot. I think about it every day. And I would give anything to change what happened, but I can't. I'm sorry for my mistakes. I tried my best.
Not over,
Sean.
It's not over. Oh God, don't let him surround you.
Just like Dad would be. We both learned a lot together, but you can make your own rules now. If we surrender, they will separate us, Daniel. And if that happens, promise me that you will always do the right thing, okay? Don't waste your power. Be smart.
Might break
like
out of
you
jail.
Already are.
If I can break out of jail,
separated.
Just to surrender.
Get out.
No, Daniel. Car fly now.
Don't make any more mistakes.
whatever happens, always remember that you're Daniel Diaz.
You know this is, I promise, Sean.
Make the car
fly. Get out of the car! Come on! There's no way out!
Up.
This is our last
so up, up and away.
Listen up.
How does the story of the Wolf Brothers end?
They fly.
Get out of the car! Now!
Alright, the choice is coming up. Fly car. Cross.
They make it to the other side.
What? You sure?
Trust me, okay? Just get us through.
Make a barrier around the car.
Oh,
make sure he.
Anyone help! Sean!
Open fire!
Daniel, concentrate.
It's too late! They're shooting at us, Daniel! This is the only way!
Daniel, concentrate.
I'm sorry, Sean, but I have to go.
What? What are you talking about?
Don't turn back for me.
What?
Daniel!
No!
I hope you'll be happy in Mexico.
Why wouldn't you come with him? You guys are home free. What the? Why? Would they have chased him across the border? Man, that stinks. So no matter what I did, they would have been separated then. The only difference is Sean would have been in jail. Daniel, that was stupid. You should stay in the car. Welcome home, Daniel. August 1st, 2017. Why does it sound like we're in church? We got a new puppy for Christmas. Oh, and he met up with Chris again. June 5th. Wow. That's like a year and a half later. Bus avoids lake tragedy due to miracle. He's using his power. Creek, Beaver Creek residents petition to repair lakeside roadways. Oh, is he back with Karen? So go visit Big Brother. November 4th, 2023. The future. At least at this point. He got his first car. Now he can travel to Mexico to go visit his brother. Years after the events of the border. So this is 2023. I guess right after he got his car. This looks like the grandparents' house. Yeah, there's the aquarium. Now it has an actual fish in it. Well, I don't know if they would have chased them, because they didn't bother chasing Sean. They just grabbed Daniel. Daniel didn't want to go, I guess? Wow, he's so tall. Kidding me. I wonder what Chris looks like right now. Oh, what's that? Is he under house arrest? Is he like being... Is he has an ankle monitor? That could even be something to inhibit his powers. But that would have stopped him from helping the bus avoid the tragedy. Is that a letter from Sean? God, talking to her daughter. Look at that. Daniel Diaz. Care of Mr. and Mrs. Reynolds. Pictures. Cassidy! Yay! Well, things aren't completely horrible. Oh my god, he has facial hair. Sucks that they got separated, but it looks like they're both doing well, all things considered. Is he ever gonna get that ankle monitor off? He said some of the sand. You know he wants to come visit, at least. So he's under house arrest, but he got a car, so... What's the sense of getting the car? Wolf Brothers. Hopefully he'll get it off soon. And then he can drive wherever the hell he wants. Well, pretty amazing. So what do you guys think? Did he jump out of the car because he really didn't want to live there? Maybe he wanted to go back with his grandparents. He was afraid to go to Puerto Lobos. He wanted to see his friend Chris again. He wanted to be able to see his mom again. I wonder if there would have been an ending where he would have gone with us. We had made some different choices if he would have come along. Did he plan this? Just to break Sean out, but not go with him to Mexico? He just wanted to save his brother. his brother would still be in jail 6 years later and for a lot more time than that. I'm thinking at least 20 years. And if he was found guilty for the first cop, even though he hadn't done it, of course. So that's murder of a police officer. That's life. That's life in jail. So forget about all the other stuff. Assaulting a police officer at the hospital, Grand Theft Auto. Now they were going to blame him for assaulting the guy at the motel, even though it was the opposite. The whole Life is Strange 2 team wants to express its sincere and humble gratitude for your amazing support, art, gifts, passions, and theories, and thanks for your patience while we were crafting these episodes. Once again, we are proud to have you on board this amazing journey. Keep on howling. Alright, let's see these choices. You decided to force the roadblock and Daniel refused. 28%. You decided to force the roadblock and Daniel accepted. Wow. I gotta go back and watch some YouTube videos, see what makes him accept it. How do you convince him? I guess a few choices on the road. A few conversations. Could have surrendered, Daniel accepted. Surrender and refused as the least. 61%. Overall, you taught Daniel to do his best to follow the rules of society. Maybe that's why he didn't force the roadblock. You taught Daniel to put himself and his brother first. Maybe that's what we needed to do in order for him to come with us. Huh. Oh, that was the ending part. You did the treasure hunt and found the hidden souvenir. 50%. Oh, 90%. Didn't finish the quest. Refused to do the treasure hunt. You overall kept your distances with Karen. 19%. Wow, we're in the minority there. Got closer to Karen. I wonder what we could have done. I mean, I did hug her. I hugged her. I didn't choose any nasty options in this, you know. I didn't make any snarky comments or anything in this episode. But 81% got closer to her somehow. Did something. You wrote a caring note to Karen. See, that's one way to get closer, I guess. I don't know if that's... I guess that's not part of it. 68%. 12% wrote a conciliating note to her. 14% didn't leave any note. And 6% left a lukewarm note. We said farewell to Arthur and Stanley. 28% didn't bother. Nice. You said farewell to Joan, 72%. 28% didn't bother. How nice. You hugged Karen before leaving. 97%. See, I knew it. At least 90% I knew would hug her. Only 3% decided not to. You guys are stone cold, I tell you. You intervened to calm Diego in the cells, 76%. Yeah. 24% decided not to. You freed the Mexican guy. You know, I didn't see an option with them to interact with them. I went by them and I didn't see anything. I did see the vigilantes, but I didn't want to... I decided to leave them where they were. Neither let them free or hurt them. So, yeah, I guess we're with the minority. 34% didn't open it. I didn't see the option. Hmm. Weird. You didn't ask Daniel to free the vigilantes. Most people chose that. 83%. You didn't hurt the vigilantes. Most people chose that. 80%. So it looks like most people did what I did. Just, like, neither hurt them nor freed them. Just kept on walking. I agree, of course. You didn't ask Daniel to kill the officers to escape the police station. No, no, don't kill them. That'd forever be on his conscience. 17% did. Daniel was told off about the skeleton and stopped skeleton. Scorpion, stop messing with it. Skeleton. Wrong game. He was told off about the skeleton, but kept messing with it. And he wasn't told off. Okay. So in the majority there. We're in the majority here as well. Daniel managed to set up Jones' sculpture with your help. He managed to set it up how he liked it. And he set it up without help. It's rare. Daniel was concerned about hurting Officer Campbell, 61%. Daniel wasn't asked to free the vigilantes. Yep, just kept on walking. He could accept or refuse. Refuse is rare. Daniel didn't have to lash out at the vigilantes, 80%. Daniel knocked out the officers, 39%. Win the majority with most of this stuff. Huh. Could have also killed the officers, locked them in a closet, or be forced to intervene because the officers got too close. I guess you just stand there too long without taking action. That happens. Daniel wasn't asked to kill the officers. Now you can ask him and he'll be okay to kill the officers or refuse. 1%, pretty rare. Was reluctant but forced to kill the officers. Oh. That's it. Is there another prelude like the other chapters? Thank you for playing and following Sean and Daniel on their journey. Give us a little prelude of the visit. The visit to Puerto Lobos. We didn't even get to see Puerto Lobos. Ah. We didn't get to see it. We got photos. I guess if Daniel would come with us, get to see it. No, we just played that. I played that. I played that. And I played that. The new Life is Strange is not here, though, of course. Wow. So what do you think? Give me your thoughts on all this. I'm so glad Cassidy came to visit him. Kind of wonder if he's just there to stay or just visiting. Wow. Oh my God. 1 of 208. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. I really hope you enjoyed this. I enjoyed it muchly myself. Pretty surprised how much I enjoyed it after the prelude, the awesome adventures of Captain Spirit. It was kind of meh to me. But this is the main attraction here. This is a great story. Say it doesn't beat out the first game to me. First Life is Strange will always be a classic to me. But this was a damn good story in itself. It should be considered in its own right. I want to thank you guys so much for watching. Hope to see you guys in another Let's Play. Always, seek adventure.